Yeah, I've been looking forward to this day for a very long time.
On a perfect day, I know that I can count on you.
As a kid, I always pictured myself getting married, at least before a lot of my brothers. And so yeah, this is a really big day that I've been looking forward to and I'm excited about. I'm glad I'm able to share that with Malia. And I told her after 6 months when we were official that we would get engaged. And so it kind of took a little longer, it took about 8 months. And so once we had a date set in stone, I actually wanted to get married sooner. I was like, hey, let's go to Vegas, we don't need a big wedding, I'm ready to go now. Let's start a family. I've always looked forward to getting married. And again, that's something I've always wanted as something part of the plan of, bringing me true happiness. And that's just one more thing added to that. So the next thing is creating a family and having a family together. So we're one step closer. And then next thing you know, we'll hopefully have a couple kids.
Juicy, I love you so much. I'm so excited for today, and it's finally here. We've planned this for a long time, and from the day I met you, I've always wanted to be with you, and I can't wait to celebrate today with you and your family and my family and our friends and loved ones, and I just can't wait to cherish every single moment. I love you with all my heart. I love you unconditionally. I know my mom is watching over us, so it'll be fun, and I can't wait to be the mother of your children and the person you grow old with. I love you. And hopefully you liked your gift that I gave you.
When I saw her, I just knew. I knew that she was my wife.
If I still see you the same way, 'cause through these trying years, we're gonna both physically change. Now, don't you know you'll always be the most beautiful woman I know? So let me reassure you, darling, that my feelings are truly unconditional. See, I'll love you when your hair turns gray, girl. I still want you if you gain a little weight, yeah. The way I feel for you will always be the same, just as long as your love don't change.
What greater thing for two individuals than to feel that they are joined together, to strengthen each other in labor, to rest on each other in sorrow, to help each other in need, to share joy, to be with one another. Whatever life has to offer, how beautiful is that?
Juicy, I love you with all my heart. I will never forget the day when I was in high school. I must have been a sophomore or junior at the time, and it was during my softball practice. I looked up at the track field and your older brother, Jesse, was coaching you on football drills or running drills. The minute I saw you, I said to myself, as well as to some of my girlfriends standing behind me, I said, damn, that boy is fine. Since then, our paths have crossed, and to say the least, it wasn't the easiest road to get here to where we are today. Before we reconnected, I prayed and prayed for God to send me a soulmate who was positive, fun-loving, enjoyed life, and of course, someone who could put up with my craziness. God truly did answer my prayers and brought you into my life. You are my better half. Anytime I'm down, sad, or crying, which was quite a bit this past year, you reminded me to be grateful for what we do have. Anytime I'm angry, which I apologize for taking things out on you, you always show me how to remain calm. Although your breathing techniques do not work for me,
because he always says, Malia, let's take a deep breath. You always follow up with the simple saying that I just need to hear. Adjust and adapt.
My vowels were a little shorter. It was 2005 when I first had my chance to lay my eyes on you. It was informal. It was very, I was just a kid. But I remember it clearly. I was in the stands at one of my brother's game. It was Joel's football game. And I remember clearly asking my brother Jesse, I said, who is this sitting right here? And he said, it's Malia. That's Cynthia's friend. And so that was my first experience of having my senior crush. And so that's why I always call Malia my senior crush. Even though I think I was in seventh grade.
Wow.
Or eighth grade. I think I was in eighth grade. I realized I was in the presence of the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. I've been to over 21 countries, and I've seen a lot of people in the world, and there's no one as beautiful as you are. From 2005, it only took me about 7 years, a year of college, and a public speaking class to have the confidence to finally ask you out to lunch. I remember we dated for a couple months, and I left to Fresno, and I was going through a phase that allowed me to be very close-minded, and unfortunately, we broke up. And I later realized there was something missing in my life. I told myself if I ever had a second chance with you, I wouldn't take it for granted. And look where we are today, and I'm so thankful that you're back into my life. And I'm excited for our future. I'm excited to build things with you. I'm excited that we have our beautiful home, and now it's time to put some babies in there.
Joshua and Malia, you have professed your love to each other in the company of your family and the circle of your friends. And by the power vested in me by the state of California, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride now. Ladies and gentlemen, I am so proud to present for the first time our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Quesada.
Today a bride, tomorrow a wife, and surely you are. I am so very proud of you, you know. Both of you, and as today said, through sickness and in health, you know, and in good times and in bad, both of you hold your hands together all the time, you know. There's going to be some rough moments, trust me, nothing's perfect. If you're looking for it, it's not out there, okay? But we all love you. That's looking for love all around you today, you know, so God bless you all. Congratulations.
You hear is not a drag, cause Mr. DJ Quick got a brand new bag, but first I got a bang bang, a boogie for the boogie to the rhythm of the ghetto-y streets. Check it out now, you trying to give me some 8-ball, but no way, I'd rather have a mimosa with Cristal and OJ, yeah, just a little something bubbly and tingly to have me walking around naked, but wait a sec.
The function's on around midnight, uh-huh. What time is it?
At the nursery, so you can slow on the anniversary. Feel me, I dip, dip, bop. So don't be looking stupid when I unfasten your bra. You know you wanna mac this because I come stronger than the IRS whenever you done got the link one on your text.
Stare in at you. I need a drink. You need one too. What is your friend? She don't look nice, but I know she will. Later on tonight.
show you my reason.
I want to start off with Malia. You have been part of Cynthia's family forever, since junior high. Best friends, and through the beginning of your journey with Cynthia, I was able to join in that. With the strong relationship you have gotten with my oldest son. So not just a best friend to Cynthia, but now a best friend to Jesse. At this time, I only knew of you, but didn't know you. As my first granddaughter was born, I began to see you more and more and hear of you. As she got older, watching your relationship with her, my heart began to grow stronger and stronger. Then I realized what Cynthia saw in you. Patience, love, and compassion. And Mama Linda also got to see the crazy side of you in New Orleans for Cynthia's bachelorette party.
You can't leave it all on you. There's things I did too. I would go out sometimes. Most of the time it was with Malia and Jesse, but there was other times when I would go out with other people. And my mom would call Malia to find out where I was at, because it was either with them. And as soon as Malia would hear my mom's name, she would hang up on her, just hang up. My mom would get so upset, like, why does Malia keep hanging up on me? And then she told my mom, it's because I would rather, hang up on you than lie. So that's a true best friend right there. That's a true best friend. Jesse, on the other hand, my mom would call him and he's like, let me find out where she's at. I'll get you the address. I'll tell you who she's with. I'll go pick her up. He would tell on me in a quick second. Yeah, he didn't care. But like, you're a sister to me. I love you unconditionally. I, like Jesse said, you are my daughter's godmother. I named her after you. I can't even explain how special you are to me, but you know the love I have for you is unconditional, no matter what. Josh, well, he's been my brother-in-law for some time now. I've known Josh for 20 plus years. I've loved him as a brother for too long. I'm just kidding. No, not too long. You know what I mean. You know what I mean. So something, I take care of my girl, Josh. I know she's going to take care of you, but it's not even something that I have to say because I know she will. But you, because I know where you live. I'll find you. So, I'm excited to see the beautiful life that you guys build together, support each other's dreams, have each other's back, and most importantly, enjoy it with family, because that, if there's one thing I've learned, is it takes a village. It takes a village to enjoy all the hardships and all the triumphs, and you're gonna have more of those. So, I love you guys. Congratulations.
There's a part of everything in through life that, like I said, you say you want things, but there's a whole other side of it to actually put the time and effort. And again, the reason why I'm bringing up the story is so that you don't forget how you were able to play in college, get a full ride scholarship, and do all the things that you did at a college level. How were you able to play for 5-6 more years overseas? Like, that had a lot to do with the time, dedication, sacrifice that you made. And what I've learned in 19 years of my relationship is it's the same thing. That stuff transfers over, and the more time that you spend on things, the more time that you, the more dedication you put into it, the more sacrifices you make for a mutual cause, the faster and better off you're gonna be. And it's, like I said, it's one thing to say it, but I know and I've seen you do it. And obviously I'm saying this because I want you to continue to do that. I want you to continue to do that in your marriage, continue to do that in your business, continue to do that in every part of your life. And you will have success just like you always have. And I love you. You know I'm always here for you. And it's been fun to watch you grow. from a skinny kid, long neck, big Adam's apple. You know, at one point I was the big brother, and then obviously he became the big brother, and it wasn't just physically, it was, I'd go out to the community and they're like, oh, aren't you Josh's brother? Yeah, he used to be my brother, but it's been fun, and I'm it's gonna be fun to continue to watch you grow, continue to start a family and do all the things that you guys wanna do. But just again, have those core principles in mind that you've always had, and you will have a lot of success. As kids get involved, I had a really, really hard time with my own wife at the time, my girlfriend, really getting her to understand that when kids come, I still come first, not the kids. Because at the end of the day, you know, there was an old guy that once told me, you know, if you don't really spend the time that you need to, even after the kids, on yourself, eventually they leave. And that's what I had to constantly remind my wife. Your son, he's gonna leave one day. Your son's gonna leave one day. Do you see his face? He looks like mine, so. But at the end of the day, you'll have each other. And so continue to grow that. Don't allow anything on the outside, anybody, to break up that. There's problems, talk about them amongst each other. Obviously you're gonna talk to your family or talk to whoever your person is to get advice, but at the end of the day, it's your decisions, and you guys know, we're gonna know each other better than anybody else. So I love you guys. Can't wait to finish watching you grow, because you guys are gonna get a lot older than I am, looks wise, so.
I never thought my life would be a bed of roses, but now I've got you, I know life is what you make it. It might get harder when the season's gonna change it, but I don't care, because I got my special lady. To call me funny, to call me honey, baby, we can do this all night. Just come on closer, just stop.